What's happening, folks, and welcome to an episode of Stars of Tomorrow, an FM20 series where we look at some of the young players on the game and we see how they develop over the course of their careers as we sim into the future. The both players I pick from a list are players I'm interested in looking at, and also players that you guys down below in the comments section suggest to me. Speaking of which, if you want to look, me to look at one of your players you think looks really good, leave his name and as much info on the player as you possibly can, especially if it's in obscure leagues. But I will also suggest you check out the playlist first and make sure that your player's not been done already, just so you don't waste your time just putting the player down that's already been done. If you're enjoying this series and this channel and you're new, hit the subscribe button. Now, if you're still here, thank you for continued support. And also, if you want to keep supporting, hit the like button as well down below. So today is a player that was a popular player to sign last year, I believe. I think it was one of the guys I kept seeing. Pelio Morella. Can play attacking mid, can play left wing and left mid as well. He's weak foot. I'll call him two-footed, to be honest with you. Plays his shots as his player trait. He is worth 1.75k. He's got a £4.9 million release clause, so you can get him early on, guys. So, again, I'm not trying to get him. I can't see why he won't be able to. Key stats here. Nothing really jumps out at this moment in time, but decent base stats, you know, for a 17-year-old. Actually, pretty good stats. So, again, good 15 flair stands out. So, I would say pretty easy to get early on. So, let's go forward first jump. Let's go. So, folks, he's still at Real Sporting, and he's now with 375k, 20 years old. Everything's gone up by at least one, but not massive amounts. Let's look at his contract information here now. The release clause is now up to £23 million. So, bear that in mind. And that's a common knowledge that I've seen. I remember famously with Martin Ødegaard, player I may do next to actually, guys, now that I mentioned him. I didn't do a review last year, did I? I don't think I did. I remember him when he first came in the game, there was like a really cheap release clause in there, wasn't there? And then you waited, like, you made a bid for him and they upped it off the new contract and upped his release clause. So maybe that could be the case here again. Again, let me know, guys, down in the comments section. Injuries, not too bad. That's slightly worrying that he's not had many injuries, but when he has them, they've been quite serious. So, okay, you have to keep an eye on that one. How has he done? Oh, God. Again, trying to look at the meaning of the first team. So, he's in Liga 2 now. He's got 10 goals and 12 assists. So, you know, he's doing all right in that division. But obviously, needs to really move, I think, out of this division, really, to, I would assume, fulfill his potential. But if you're doing a Real Sporting save, which maybe one of you is, he's going to nail it in vision for you, looking at this. So, yeah, next jump. Let's go. So, folks, again, he's still at Real Sporting, which is slightly weird. 11 goals, 10 assists this season. He can play in all positions, play traits, kill balls often, plays his shots. Injury record, not too bad since the rocky start down here. Career stats. So he's now, they were in the Liga briefly. He got 11 goals and 13 in the Liga 2, then 12 and 6. First year in the Liga, got 7 goals and 4 assists. First time got relegated, not bad. For me, it doesn't sound bad. And then relegated again, 12 goals and 11 and 10. This is not really working out this year for me. I think this is basically down for he's not at a top club, or he's not in top league either. But hey, this is going to go sometimes on reviews. I think we're going to do one more jump at least, but I've got a sneaky feeling that I know this is going to play out. Well, folks, he's moved to Lyon. He's moved and we've seen 15 free kick taking and 14 crossing. So, and pace is not great. He's got more player traits. Runs the ball down the left, tries to kill ball off him, plays his shots, tries long range free kicks. He's got long shots 13 and 15 free kicks. So, yeah, workable. Injuries, let's have a look here. Okay. Is he injury prone? Potentially. Looking at that. How has he done though? How has he done then? So we saw him in Liga 2. There he got 12 goals. That's pretty standard for him. Back in the Liga, got 3, 2 and 3. Went to Lyon for 70.5. Didn't play. didn't play. This is the common thing I'm noticing with this series. I love this series, by the way. It's my favourite series to do. But AI, dudes, if you're going to sign a player, at least play them. So yeah, we're going to do another couple of year jump, but I think he's better than this. The base stats are really good at start for him. Send him early on, folks. Get him developed. If you've got a godlike cam, maybe you can ease him in more. But yeah, let's go a couple more years and see if it actually works out at Lyon. So still at Lyon. Done a couple of more years, and the pages are basically the same. Well, there's like a lot more. But it's good development, but easy to read him, isn't it? So runs the ball down the left. Gets forward wherever he can. He tries clear balls, plays his shot, digs his tempo, tries long-range free kicks, and likes ball playing defeat. Injuries, again, this is worrying for me. About after you go into the in-depth scouting of him, I can't really confirm his injury proneness. So at Lyon, just not being played, is it? He's a squad player, isn't he? He's a squad player. They've bought a cheap squad player. But I think it's simply put, get him early on, get him out of Liga 2, and develop him yourself. And I think there's definitely building blocks here for a decent player. You're not far, I mean, I'm not trying to oversell him here, but you've got 14 crossing, 15 free kicks, 13 long shots, good technique, 14 technique, 16 flair, physicality, not great, but that's not, the composure is 14. You're not far, if you get up to 15, get this up to like 15, get his passing up to 4-15 as well. You've got a decent player here. He's not expensive, but I think it's a combination of just not being played enough and in a lower division that's inhibited him. But he's not that expensive at the start, is he? So maybe it's a case of buy him early, get him in your team, plan for long term with him, and you can get more out of him than it's showing here. So thank you so much for watching, folks. Not every review we can do is going to turn out brilliantly. I only do them once. I don't do redos. I don't think it's realistic to do that because FM saves don't work that way either. My policy is always based, if you give me a player, I'll do it once and then go from there. If there's a mitigating circumstance, I will obviously look at that, like injuries or lack of playing time. I think in this case, it was not at a top club early on. Maybe could be here with him. Also, commission of that and injuries. So I don't redo them, guys, because you don't redo a save on FM. If you want to get it work out, does he go and buy somebody else? So yeah, I think this guy, if you get him early on, I think you'll get more of him than you're seeing here. But yeah, don't forget, guys, down below, leave a comment down below on any player you would like me to look at. Next player I'm going to do, I've got two in mind. I'm not quite certain what I'm going to do next, but I know it's probably another cam, to be honest with you. Can try and find, I'm in a bit of a cam mood at the minute. So we'll see. But obviously, guys, if you make a suggestion down below in the interim period before this video or after it, I will obviously make sure your player is done the next time. If not next episode, the one after that. Like I said, if in case you're wondering about the schedule for these uploads, if you're a fan of this series, you're getting one video today, as you can see, because I'm here. Tomorrow, you get a Wolves episode, and then after that is the next episode. So let's say today's Monday. Tomorrow's Tuesday, so it'd be Wolves. Wednesday being another start of tomorrow. But until next time, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget, if you enjoyed the video, hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you wanted to say enjoy the video, that's completely fine as well. And if you are new to the channel and you like this idea, this series, you want to see more from it, then there's a big button down below saying subscribe. Go and hit that button and you will hopefully enjoy the future content. But until next time, thank you for watching. Bye-bye.